Okay. So in the last class, we discussed about what is unsteady state. So it means that the temperature parameter will vary with respect to time. Then we discussed about lumped parameter analysis. So from the lumped parameter analysis, we assume that solid will be having very large thermal conductivity, so that the conduction resistance will be very small, and the temperature gradients within the system at all the positions are negligible. It means the temperature will remain same at all position within the system. And actually the whole body behaves as a lump with almost same temperature at all position. So such an analysis is known as lumped parameter analysis. So for this lumped parameter analysis, we have derived the equation for temperature distribution and as well as instantaneous heat transfer and total heat transfer, and we have shown that so during lumped parameter analysis, okay, the temperature, okay, with respect to time, we have plotted, and also we have seen the exponential heating and exponential cooling of the curves. Okay, and also we have discussed about the criteria for lumped parameter analysis by defining a dimensionless number known as Biot number. Okay, Biot number is given by HLC by K, where H is the heat transfer coefficient, LC is the characteristic length, and K is the thermal conductivity. And also we learned that lumped parameter analysis will be applicable if the Biot number is less than or equal to 0.1. So in the Biot number, okay, there is one parameter which is characteristic length. Okay, so here I have shown you the characteristic length for some common shapes. Okay, this will be useful while solving the numericals. Okay, the first one, I have taken plane wall having a thickness of L. So characteristic length is given by volume by area. This, you know, characteristic length is given by volume by area. That should be equal to, volume is actually what, the area into thickness will give you the total volume of that plane wall. Okay, and surface area, here I have taken, okay, if you take a plane wall, front there will be surface area, and as well as back side also the surface area will be there. Okay, so if you along the, if you take the thickness, you can neglect the heat transfer along the thickness, only the front surface. Okay, if you take this is a plane wall, whatever this area as well as the back side area, okay, so it is two times area, that is what I have written. So along this is the thickness, if I take this is the thickness, okay, along that thickness we can neglect the heat transfer compared to the plane area, okay, on the front side as well as on the back side. So total surface area will be, okay, two times of area. So here area gets cancels, so remaining is L by 2. Okay, L by 2 or thickness, okay, whatever the total thickness is there, divided by 2 will give you the characteristic length for a plane wall. Next, sphere having a radius R. Okay, characteristic length, again same formula, volume by area. Volume of a sphere, you know, 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, whereas surface area of the sphere is 4 pi r square. Surface area of the sphere is 4 pi r square. Simplify. Okay, so you are going to get r by 3. Okay, 4 pi r square, 4 pi, 1 r will go, 1 r will remain in the numerator, divided by 3. Okay, next one, cylinder. Okay, long cylinder of having a radius r. The characteristic length is wall by volume by area. What is the volume of the cylinder? It is given by pi r square into l. That means pi r square is a cross section area. A cross section area into l. And what is the surface area of the cylinder? It is nothing but pi dl or 2 pi rl. I have written the formula in terms of radius. So it is 2 pi rl. Actually, if you take whole cylinder, okay, suppose along the cross section area also heat has been convected, then you have to add plus pi r square plus pi r, that is plus 2 pi r square. Okay, or if it is a long cylinder, you can neglect the heat transfer in the circular section of the cylinder. Okay, so you can take approximately the total surface area to be as 2 pi rl. So here pi r, if you just simplify, you're going to get r by 2. Next, cube. Okay, volume of a cube is L cube, and surface area. Okay, there are totally 6 surface. No, okay, correct. No, for a cube there are 6 surface. Okay, 6 into area of each side is L square. 6 L square. It will give you the total surface area of the cube. Volume, you know. Okay, L cube, because L length into, you know, general formula L into B into H. For a cube, all the sides will be equal. So it will be L cube divided by 6 L square. It will be L by 6. Okay, this this characteristic length will be useful while solving the numericals. Okay, try to remember this formula. Okay, next. So we have is HAT by rho VC. This term was there in the exponential, no? That theta by theta I will be equal to exponential of minus HAT by rho VC. That same thing I have taken here. Actually, that is equal to Biot number and Fourier number. Let us see how it is. So here it is HT. H means heat transfer coefficient. A is the surface area. T is the time. Rho is the density. V is the volume. C is the specific heat. Okay. So here HT by rho LC into C I have written. What you know? What is characteristic length? It is nothing but volume by area. Okay. Here there is a volume. Okay. A is there in the numerator. You take area to the denominator. It will become V by A, which is nothing but characteristic length. Okay, remaining terms I have written as it is. That should be equal to H. Okay, here first term H I have written as it is. This LC by K. Okay, what I have done is I have multiplied with LC by K and divided by LC by K. Okay, that is, or LC by K into K by LC. Okay, both will cancel, so it will become 1. Understood? What we have done is there is a LC by K, and also we have here K by LC. Already one LC is there in the denominator, so that LC into LC will become LC square. Okay, so LC by K into K by LC, the value will be 1. It doesn't have any effect. Okay, so I have multiplied with K by LC. Here I have multiplied with LC by K, so that the value does not change. Into time, T is their time. Okay, then rho into C, correct? No, so what I have done here is LC by K into K by LC I have added. Why I have had it like this? Because this term will become Biot number. HLC by K is nothing but Biot number. Then Next, okay, this k by rho c I have denoted by alpha. K by rho c I have denoted by alpha into t by lc square. T by LC square, that is nothing but Fourier number, Biot number into Fourier number. So HAT by rho VCV is also equal to Biot number into Fourier number. Okay, and alpha, this is nothing but what? Thermal diffusivity. Already you might have come across this. The alpha is nothing but thermal diffusivity, which is defined as a ratio of thermal conductivity by thermal capacity. Okay, heat conducted by heat stored. And okay, this alpha t by lc square is known as Fourier number. This is also a dimensionless time number. This is also a dimensionless number. Okay, the Fourier number is useful in transient heat problems. Okay, this will tell you the degree of penetration of heating or cooling. So Fourier number will be useful. You are going to come across later when the Biot number is greater than 0.1. Okay, this number will also come into picture. Okay, or for larger value of Fourier number, okay, small time will be required. That is significance is there. Okay, that will come across later. Next, we'll move on to numericals. First problem, a steel ball of 5 cm diameter initially at a uniform temperature of 450 degrees Celsius is suddenly placed in an environment at 100 degrees Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient between the steel ball and the fluid is 10 watt per meter square Kelvin. For steel, specific heat is 0.46 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Density they have given, thermal conductivity they have given. 35 watts per meter Kelvin. Calculate the time required for the ball to reach a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius. Also find the rate of cooling after 1 hour. Right. So in the problem, what they have given? It's a ball of 5 centimeter diameter. Radius is 0.025 meter. Initially at a uniform initial temperature, they have given out Ti is equal to 450 degree Celsius. Just put on the light. Initial temperature is 450 degree Celsius. Okay, it is placed in environment at 100 degree Celsius. So ambient temperature is 100 degree Celsius. Okay, so here also I have written heat transfer coefficient is 10 watt per meter square Kelvin. Right, and this C rho I have written here. C is stands for specific heat, rho stands for density. Okay, and in the problem, what they have asked, you have to find the time required for the ball to reach a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius. So what is the time required to reach the temperature of 150 degrees? That is what you have to find. Also, you have to find the rate of cooling after 1 hour. Okay, so first, we have to find the Biot number because first you have to check whether you can apply the lumped parameter analysis concept or not. So you have to find the Biot number. So first I have found the characteristic length. Volume by area is nothing but R by 3. I have told you just now steel ball is a sphere. So you can take R by 3. Radius divided by 3, you are going to get the characteristic length. Once you got characteristic length, Biot number, you know the formula HLC by K, where H is the heat transfer coefficient, K is the thermal conductivity. H value they have given 10. Okay, characteristic length. Okay, is nothing but R by 3, 0.025 by 3, or you can directly put this value 8.33 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Thermal conductivity is how much? 35. Okay, that is what I have written. You have got the Biot number 2.381 into 10 to the power of minus 3, which is less than 0.1. So you can apply the lumped parameter analysis, and you know the formula for temperature distribution. theta by theta I is equal to exponential minus HAT by rho VC, or it is also equal to exponential minus HT rho into characteristic length into C, because I have told you now volume is in the denominator. When A comes to the denominator, it will become V by A, which is nothing but characteristic length. Okay. So this you know, what is theta by theta I? What is theta? Temperature at any point of time minus ambient temperature. What is theta I? Theta I is nothing but initial temperature minus ambient temperature. Okay, that is what I have written here. That should be equal to exponential minus h into t. That is what it is there, h into t rho LC into C. So rho density is 7800, that has been given in the data, and characteristic length we have found now 8.33 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into specific heat. They have given 0.46 kilojoules per kg. Okay, this is very very important. They have given in kilojoules, you have to convert into joules. So that is why I have multiplied with 10 power 3. This is very important. Okay, otherwise you are going to get wrong answer. Usually they will be given in, they will give specific heat in terms of kilojoules per kg Kelvin. You have to convert into joules by multiplying with 10 power 3. Okay, next. So this is temperature at any point of time is 150 degree. At 150 degree, that is what they have asked. At 150 degree, what is the time required? To reach a temperature of 150 degree, what is the time required? And ambient temperature is 100, and the initial temperature of that steel ball, steel ball is 450. Initial temperature is 450, they have given in the problem, as well as this 100 degree also has been given in the problem. Okay, and they have asked to reach a temperature of 150 degree, what is the time required? So how will you solve? You have to apply ln on both the sides, natural logarithm. Okay, ln of this, that is equal to, okay, this law exponential is there, is nothing but e to the power of this. So it is when you apply ln e to the base e, it will become 1. That, okay, understood? No, log a to the base a is 1. Similarly, ln e to the base e will be 1. That will become minus t by this 2989.9. Okay, if you just simplify this, you are going to get this value. Okay, and ln of this you find out and get the value of time. It will be 5.1818 in 10 power 3 seconds, or in terms of hours, it will be 1.616 hours. So this is the time required. Okay, next one, rate of cooling after 1 hour. So this formula we have derived, dT by dT. Okay, dT by dT, that will be equal to minus HA by rho VC. That formula we are going to use whenever they have asked rate of cooling after some time. Okay, then they have asked, you have to use this formula. You have to remember this formula. Minus HA by rho VC into theta I. That is nothing but TI minus TI into exponential of minus HAT by rho VC. You know all the values. You have to just substitute and get the answers. Okay. So this you know, HA by rho VC. Here we have done this H by rho VC. HA by rho VC, okay, that we have put. It will be 2989.98 into TI minus TA, 450 minus 100 into exponential of, okay, minus HAT by rho VC. Okay, just put these values, you are going to get. See here, this HA by rho VC we have already calculated, that is 2989.9, that I have put directly. HA by rho VC already we have calculated, and here also exponential of this HA by rho VC is 1 by 2989.98, and time, okay, for time, okay, listen here, for time they have asked 1 hour, I have put 3600 seconds. Okay, you know 1 hour is 60 into 60 or 3600 seconds. You have to convert your hour into seconds and put the value for time. Okay, so this you know for initial temperature 450 minus ambient temperature 100 degree. Okay, substitute and you are going to get minus 0.035 centigrade per second. Okay, now go to the next problem. So in this problem they have given 50 centimeter into 50 centimeter copper slab 6 mm thick at a uniform temperature of 350 degree Celsius suddenly as its surface temperature to 30 degree Celsius. This is what temperature? Ambient temperature. 30 degree Celsius is the ambient temperature. Okay, and this is a like a plain wall having 6 mm thick. Suddenly as its surface temperature 30 degree Celsius, find the time at which slab temperature becomes 100 degree Celsius. That is T, okay, is 100 degree and they have given rho C, K, H. Also find the rate of cooling after 60 seconds. Last time they had given 1 hour. Now this problem they have asked for 60 seconds. Right. So temperature at any point of time. That means you have to calculate what is the time required to reach this 100 degree Celsius. That is what they have asked. Find the time at which the slab temperature becomes 100 degree. Can you see here? Find the time at which the slab temperature becomes 100 degree Celsius. So that will be TT, 100 degree Celsius, rho, C, K, everything they have given. Okay, and this length into breadth. Okay, this 50 centimeter into 50 centimeter is nothing but length into breadth, 0.05 meter, 0.0, and thickness. Okay, actually, the thickness we have denoted by L. That is why I have taken L, because while I was telling characteristic length, the thickness has been defined by parameter L. That is why I have written L only here also. L equal to 6 mm. So here I have expanded and written length, breadth, okay, like this. And initial temperature of this slab is 350 degrees Celsius. Okay. So this is a problem on plain wall. Because they have given length, breadth and thickness. Okay, it's a problem on plain wall. So first, as usual, you have to check the lumped parameter analysis applicable or not. So for that, you have to find the Biot number. As usual, the procedure is volume by area, L by 2, 6 into 10. Okay, thickness is 6 into 10 to the power of minus 3 by 2. It is nothing but 3 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Yeah, correct, no? Thickness divided by 2 is the characteristic length for plain wall. Next, Biot number is HLC by K. H by K, characteristic length is L by 2. I so just substitute all the value. You know all the values. Okay, H, L, E transfer coefficient. Just substitute and get the value of Biot number. It will be 8.108 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Okay, which is less than 0.1. So it means that lumped parameter analysis applicable, and you know the formula theta by theta is equal to exponential minus HAT by rho VC, that is also equal to exponential of minus HT by rho LC into C, because LC is what characteristic length, volume by area. You are going to get this formula again. Just substitute the values whatever they have given and arrive at time. It is just like previous problem. Only thing is that was a sphere problem and this problem is on plain wall. Everything they have given, only you have to find time. So how will you do it? You are going to same thing, apply log on both the sides. You are going to get a time 155 seconds in terms of hours. Okay, it will be 0.043 hours. Okay, so how will you get it? You divide by 60 into 60, 3600, you are going to get it in hours. So rate of cooling after 60 seconds, again the same, you know the formula, I told you to remember this formula. Okay, so HA by rho VC, already it has been calculated here, you can see here, no, 102.6, that 100, everything. 102.6, TI minus TA, you know, exponential of minus Okay, time. Time is 60 seconds. That is what I have put here, minus 60. HA by rho VC already I have calculated. If you want, again, you can put all the values and you can calculate. That way also you can do it. Okay, since we have already calculated, okay, it will reduce the time. That's all. Okay, and it will be minus 1738 centigrade per second. Okay, here I forgot to tell last problem. The negative sign is there, no? Because why it is negative sign? Because the slab, copper slab is losing heat, or there is a decrease in internal energy. Okay. Heat lost by the copper slab. Okay, that is why it is negative sign. Okay, next problem. Okay, there is an egg with mean diameter of 4 cm initially at 25 degrees Celsius. It is placed in boiling water for 4 minutes and found to be consumer taste. For how long should a similar egg for same consumer be boiled when taken from refrigerator at 2 degrees Celsius? And they are given all the properties of the egg, thermal conductivity H, specific heat as well as density. Okay, so you try to understand this problem. What is there, what they have asked? So they have asked time, okay, but in initially what they have told, it's a egg with 4 cm diameter. Okay, so you can take approximately that egg to be in the, actually it is, egg is a oval shape, but still we can assume egg as a sphere. And initial temperature they have given 25 degrees Celsius. 25 degrees Celsius, it is placed in boiling water for 4 minutes. Okay, so the boiling water temperature they have not given. You can assume boiling water temperature at one atmospheric pressure to be as 100 degrees Celsius. That we will assume. They have not told, they have not given, but they have told that it's a boiling water. Okay, and egg has been boiled for 4 minutes and it found to be consumer taste. Okay, so if for that taste, what is the temperature first we will find? You know the water temperature 100 degrees Celsius, initial temperature of the egg. Okay, and time also you know, and remaining properties of the egg they have given. First you have to find what is the temperature reached by the egg from 25 degrees Celsius to reach the consumer taste. That temperature you have to find. Then, okay, then only you can find what is the time required. Suppose the egg initial temperature is taken from the refrigerator, which is at 2 degrees Celsius. Understood? Okay, so first you have to find the temperature. Okay, for 4 minutes, what will be the temperature of the egg? Okay, when the egg is boiled for 4 minutes, then, okay, so the same, okay, or another egg which has been taken from the refrigerator, which is initially having temperature of 2 degrees Celsius, okay, when you start boiling the egg, what is the time taken? That is what we have to find. Okay, I told you, okay, egg you can assume it as sphere, and boiling temperature of water is 100 degrees Celsius. You can assume it. They have not given. You can assume boiling temperature of water to be as 100 degree. Okay, first we'll find the Biot number. You know, characteristic length is volume by area. Since it's a sphere, R by 3. Okay, calculate. Our radius they have given, because diameter is 4 cm, radius will be 2 cm. In terms of meter, it will be 0.02 divided by 3. You are going to get 6.667 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Next, you are going to get, you find the Biot number HLC by K, which is nothing but H by K into R by 3. That will be HU they have given, no? 125, radius 0.02, thermal conductivity of the egg 12 into 3. Okay, get the value of biot number. This value is less than 0.1, so lumped parameter analysis is applicable. Next, we will try to find what is a consumer test temperature. Okay, so time they have given 4 minutes. Okay, temperature you have to find here minus ambient temperature. Okay, that will be 100 degree. That is the boiling temperature of the water. Initial temperature of the egg is 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, next exponential minus HT by into rho into LC into C. Okay, exponential H E transfer coefficient they have given. Okay, time they have given 4 minutes. The egg will be boiled for 4 minutes from 25 degrees Celsius in a boiling water, that is which is at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay. Rho density, LC characteristic length we have calculated, right? And C is the specific heat, that also has been given. Okay, where they have given specific heat. Okay, they have given in joules directly. I have put in joules only, 2000. Okay, so just substitute and get the value of what is the temperature. It will be 87.6 degrees Celsius. So this is a consumer test temperature. So now the egg is taken from the refrigerator, which is at 2 degrees Celsius. So the consumer test temperature is 87.6 degrees Celsius. So what is the time taken when the egg is taken, when the egg is heated from 2 degrees Celsius? That is what they have asked in the problem. When the egg is taken from the refrigerator at 2 degrees Celsius, what is the time required to reach this 87.6 degrees Celsius? So for TT, I am going to write 87.6 minus ambient, same boiling temperature of water is 100 degrees. Initial temperature of the egg now is 2 degrees Celsius. Understood? This is very important because the egg has been taken from the refrigerator, which is at 2 degrees Celsius. Now, what is the time required? Exponential of this one, as usual, 125 is a H. Same rho LC into C. That when you do it, you are going to get this 133.334. Just simplify this and you apply ln on both the sides, as usual, get the value of time. This will be 275.63 seconds, or in terms of minute, it is 4.6 minutes. Okay, divide by 60, you are going to get in minutes. You know how to convert seconds to minutes. Understood? Next, we'll solve some multiple choice questions, MCQ. First one, what is lumped heat capacity analysis? This you know, lumped heat analysis means the temperature will remain same. Analysis of a system which is assumed to be at uniform temperature. They have given non-uniform temperature, either uniform or non-uniform. Okay, this is actually uniform temperature. I told you, lumped parameter analysis means the temperature does not vary with respect to position, or the temperature remains same at all the points within the system. So biot number is given by, biot number is nothing but ratio of conduction resistance to convective resistance. Ratio of internal conduction resistance to external convection resistance. They have given ratio of, they have given reverse convection to conduction, or another multiplying internal conduction, none of the above. It is, answer is B. It is given as ratio of conduction resistance to convective resistance. Okay, last MCQ. Okay, so what should be the biot number to assume the body at uniform temperature? That is lumped parameter analysis. I told you biot number should be less than 0.1. The answer is A. Okay, thank you.